If you don't already know about Sofdr.io, you are really missing out in the no-code space. Sofdr is an incredible tool that allows you to build a front-end web app for Airtable. So Airtable gets to run as your back-end database, and Sofdr can do whatever you want on the front end. It's an incredibly flexible tool, and Sofdr's management continues to improve and enhance the features week over week. In this video, Ali Alosa from Gap Consulting is gonna be sitting down with Mariam from Sofdr for a one-on-one interview. Ali's gonna dive deep with Mariam and really get behind how she got into the no-code space and why she's building Sofdr and why she's so passionate about it. But before we get into that interview, I do want to mention that this is an abridged version for YouTube. We offer full access to these interviews in our Airtable Mastermind group. It's a group of folks who are all Airtable experts, and we help each other level up. So if you're looking for a little bit of support, you might want to check out Airtable Mastermind, as well as get access to all of the full interviews that we've done here on the channel. But without further ado, let's hop right into that interview. Here comes Ali and Mariam.
Well, hello, Mariam. Thank you so much for joining us today. I'm so excited to talk to you. You're the co-founder and CEO of Sofdr, if that's correct.
Yes, absolutely. Hey, everyone. Also excited to be here. Thanks a lot for the invite.
Absolutely. I'm so excited to talk to you. I've been hearing so much about your product recently. It's really taken off, and like a lot of people are using it, which is awesome. How did you get started with Sofdr?
Well, that's a good question. So we started back in a year ago, and the reason for us to start Sofdr in the first place was that both of the co-founders are coming from product and tech background. So we ourselves have been building Sofdr products for ages. And what we just kept noticing in every other company we worked for, we just kept building the same things over and over, whether it's authentication, payments, messaging, etc. Every company hires an entire team to just build payment integrations, etc. Right? And then the last 7 years, mainly with all of these companies, we have been in leadership roles, and we just have been hiring engineering talent as well, and have seen firsthand the scarcity of engineering talent, which is just crazy, right? The world cannot keep up with producing more engineers. And we just don't, I mean, I personally don't believe, but I guess many people will agree that everyone is not going to become a coder or engineer at some point. So we thought, why not have a platform where all of these repetitive things are offered as building blocks, basically pre-made, and then companies or individuals just build on top what's only unique to their business. That's really how we came to building Sofdr in the first place. And it got evolved, of course, over time. Originally, we didn't start with Airtable, and we just kind of started just working with different backends, etc., and then figured that there is huge demand with Airtable, like customers are just asking for it. And then we kind of started using Airtable as one of the first use cases for a backend.
That's awesome. So before that, were you kind of thinking like people could just feed in their data from like using any other sort of like Google Sheets or anything like that before Airtable?
Not that much Google Sheets, but also their own data or through APIs, which is still something some people want, but especially having everything, also the data inside Sofdr. So Sofdr could handle all of the databases, but then we just realized, you know, most of the people, especially if we talk about non-tech people within companies or just individuals, they already use Airtable for storing all of their data, and it just didn't make sense to, like, we were not at that point, we were not going to create a better Airtable, which get that adopted. So we just really went with the demand.
Absolutely. And I love the idea of Sofdr, because you have those building blocks, those like blocks that you can drag in, like a call to action at the very top of the page, because that is correct. Like you see every website out there generally has that same kind of look and feel with like the different sections. And I think it's really cool. It's kind of turning a web design into a point and click, just like Airtable is doing with software development.
Yeah, exactly. What we noticed, like the biggest gap when we talk to customers, and when we ourselves actually wanted to build a website for our for our company, we just like noticed the gap in the market, which is some of the existing tools are tools to build static websites, but they're really simplistic and you can't build complex or powerful functionality. And then on the other spectrum, there are tools like Bubble and some others which allow you building powerful stuff, but then they are so complex and really difficult to learn that people just give up, right? Most of the people do not understand these technical concepts and they just are not going to spend the time to learn it. So we thought really like, and in order, we believe in order for people to really adopt no-code tools and be able to build something really quickly, fast and still powerful, it has to be easy to use and also still have the functionality. And like the building block concept from the very beginning was something we tested out. And it turned out that this is something that makes it so easy for people to just use and build a website or web app, because it is so repetitive, as you mentioned, right? Every other website or a web app has the same components, whether it's even like authentication, payments, or just a hero block in your website. So what I can demo is, especially for people who are new to software, I can maybe demo first how you create an application and then show a real running application. So this is the dashboard where you land in. And let's say we want to create a new application. It can be a website, can also be an application web app. So the main generic concept of software, as you mentioned, are the blocks, right? There is your pages, but then it's the blocks that are the core parts of your application. So you can have, like every other website, you can have headers, hero, sections, features. So let's say I want to add a header and then I can add hero block. And then I'm just gonna add maybe a team section and add a footer as well. And yeah, so I almost have my application up and running now. I can publish and check how it looks. Of course, this is just the basics. And then the way it works is basically everything that you see on this page is configurable and changeable as in design wise. So I can add as many links as I like. I can remove some links. I can add buttons or remove buttons if I don't need to. I can upload images where we also offer pre-built libraries like stock images and illustrations.
Ooh, that's really big. That's really cool.
And yeah, you can change the text here. And it's real-time updating, so you see on the left side what's happening. And you can also, of course, integrate buttons, different actions. You can open page, scroll to section, and other actions as well. I'll show that later, like sending data back to Zapier, Integromat, or back to Airtable, etc. So let's say if this is part of my website, then I can just simply add another member, add data here, so I directly immediately have all the results. This is just simply the part of, yeah, the main kind of core part of how do you use building blocks. And then we also offer different integrations, of course, Airtable and all of these other integrations to have a real website up and running, to be able to do also Stripe integration, Stripe checkout, so you can actually charge money from your customers. You can integrate analytics, chat, and all of the other stuff. And then as well, you can configure all of the default styles of your entire page, entire application. So you can say all the buttons should be different backgrounds, the font, etc. So this is high level for the project. However, as I mentioned, we can also change everything on this page design wise. So I can also change a background color, set a background image, or change the style of this button. From rounding to, yeah, as you can see, it changes. So anything like element by element, you can configure if you like to. So this is my first page. Let's say this is the homepage of my company. And as a company, I'm working with clients and I have consultants who are doing projects for these clients. And then I want to charge them. And as a manager or as an employee, I want to log in, see all the projects and see all the tasks, add a task, et cetera, et cetera. And also I can give access to my clients to log in and see what's the status of their project. So here I can say, okay, on the login, so there is some already because this is a template, there is some data already pre-configured here. So let's say I'm logging in as a manager. So these are the configured all using Airtable, the roles and permissions. I'm going to show before logging in, I'll show the database as well. Do you see the Airtable?
Awesome. Yes.
Yeah. So here are listed, all of the people are listed here, and there is role field, as you can see, client manager or consultant. And then it's just personal information. And then there's projects. Each project is linked to a specific client, and then who is working on this project as a consultant, and then the managers can see everything. There's tasks, obviously, connected to projects and invoices that are linked to projects.
Awesome.
So here now I'm logging in as a manager. And this is basically my client portal. So the same thing could be seen also by clients. Just you can define which areas and what information you want to show them. So in this case, because I'm a manager, I see everything. I can, let's say, click on specific project, see all the details, see the tasks related to it, project invoices, if there are any, and I can add a new task. As soon as I add the task, it's going to appear in the tasks list. And then I can look up for all of the clients that I have. Let's say I can see a client profile, see the projects they own. I can see my own team as a company, as a manager. So these are the consultants, for example, who are working on the project. Then I can see which projects they are working on. Of course, you could add as much information as you like on the page. So this is a cool thing. It doesn't limit you to this, what you see. It's completely up to you what page you can construct.
Oh my goodness. Like it's mind-boggling how powerful this is, really. Like you know, and you could really build any number of things with this product. It has come so far since the first time I tried it too. You guys are continually pushing out new updates and features, and I think that's just so cool. I'm super excited to see what comes next for you guys too.
Yeah, thank you. Yes, we try to move fast, but also some of the core things that are mentioned here are really the core things. People build so many interesting and creative things that we cannot imagine as use cases. Like people are really creative. You just, like, we ourselves sometimes cannot imagine how this blog can be used otherwise, but when we see something built, it's really insane what people can imagine and what they can use it for, and they just built completely unique applications with it.
Oh my goodness, and it's so exciting to see, and it's that really jives with the whole, with what Airtable is all about too, because people can be super creative. This is really impressive. I'm really excited to try this out myself. Like, I might try building a project on this myself.
Yes, please do, and let us know how it goes.
I do.
Hear what you think and how easy it is for you. Really, one of the core aspects of software is the ease of use, simplicity, but still having the power behind it.
Absolutely. Well, I can see that was very easy and simple to set up, and it looks very sleek, and I'm super impressed.
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Of course. Well, Mariam, thank you so much for joining us today. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Likewise.
Where can our listeners go to learn more about Softr?
Well, obviously our website, softr.io, and you can also find more information and updates on our Twitter, which is, again, Twitter, softr.io_. And thank you so much for having me. It was great to chat.
Well, as I said before, if you haven't already heard of Softr, you definitely understand now why they're so powerful. You can build literally anything you can imagine with their incredible front end and still use Airtable as the back end. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.